Good Day Columbus on ABC 6 starts with this breaking news alert.
Good morning. Thank you for joining us on this Monday, July 11th. I'm Jessica Ralston.
And I'm Kurt Ludlow. We are going to start with some breaking news in the Short North, where another shooting has sent a man to the hospital.
This happened right at the corner of North High and East 4th Avenue just after 2:30 this morning. That's right in front of the popular bar and music venue, Scully's. Police say the 23-year-old victim doesn't know who shot him. He didn't even see it happen. He just heard the gunfire and felt pain in his leg. He told police he was waiting in line for a food cart when a man started to harass women around him. Others intervened, and that's when the shot was fired. Detectives could still develop a suspect. They're checking the surveillance cameras in the area for evidence. In the meantime, that victim's being treated at the hospital. He's expected to be okay. Since last summer, though, there have been a string of shootings in the Short North. The very latest, June 27th, that's when dozens of shots were fired at the corner of High Street and Hubbard. On June 19th, three people were shot outside of a club named Seesaw. Police say all of those victims from those shootings will recover.
All right, good morning, everyone. Time now is 6:01. As you're heading out the door today, should not see any issues on the roads as far as weather goes, other than maybe some sun glare. The sun comes up in 11 minutes from now. Mild and dry morning for you as you're hitting the roads. Not too much traffic just yet there on 670 behind us. We'll get a check of traffic coming up with Katie here in a second. But it's a bit of a mild morning. We're at 61 in Delaware right now. The cool spot, though, is London, 59. We're still at 66 here in Columbus. So again, it's a bit of a mild morning for you outside. A little cooler in some spots. Regional View shows there's rain out in Iowa. So today we stay mostly sunny, but that will start moving in for us tonight. So be prepared for that early tomorrow morning. And as you're heading out the door today, we get to 89 degrees for the high. By overnight tonight, notice some scattered showers and storms there at 4 a.m. tomorrow morning. A little cooler tomorrow as we get into the mid-80s. And as we continue on to the rest of the week, we'll be dealing with the chance of the showers and storms kind of sticking around as we head into later into the week. So today, heading out the door, not expecting any weather delays today. If you're flying out of the airport, 89 for the high, a little hotter in Orlando, getting up to 92. Tomorrow, though, we could see maybe a little bit of rain in the early morning. Still, I don't think it's going to cause any delays. We'll take you through the rest of the week coming up. Back to the desk.
More breaking news overnight. A crash sent a car into a restaurant in downtown Columbus. This happened about 3 a.m. at the corner of North High and Spring Streets. One person was taken to Grant Medical Center and is expected to be okay. There was also some minor damage to the Haveli Bistro restaurant. Katie?
All right, so we are working our way into the 6 o'clock hour. We're going to check in with how folks are moving on 270 just to show you that traffic is very light over here on the west outer belt. The north side really in good shape as well, right by Smoky Row Road. Those east and westbound lanes bear plenty of room to get more folks out for this hour. You can see right here that our board is looking good. This is an accident that came in West Broad Street at Hay Avenue. We're going to get to Mike Kilburn in a second, but that's that little dot that you see right there. I'm not sure exactly if that's causing any problems or not. We're seeing right here 670. Westbound coming all the way in towards downtown Columbus. Your commute from Gahanna is in good shape on time this morning. And out to the west a little bit further, or out to the east a little bit further, I should say, 161 westbound lanes really looking good, working their way in from New Albany Road to 270 this morning. So as for that West Broad and Hay Avenue, let's go out to Mike Kilburn and check in with him to see if it is, in fact, something that we need to worry about this morning.
Yeah, good morning, Katie. We just check that out, and there is nothing in that intersection, so we're going to clear that. Again, that came in as an injury accident, but it does not exist. So we're going to head out towards Alum Creek and Toy Road. They're calling a medical emergency out there. Sounds like they're shutting some lanes of Alum Creek down right around Toy Road. So we're going to check in on that. We'll let you know what we find there. Live and on your side in Mobile Track, I'm Mike Kilburn.
New this morning, a crash in Ross County taking a deadly turn. A man from Michigan died when he crashed into the trailer of a semi. This was on U.S. 35 at Limerick Road Sunday around 4:30 in the afternoon. Ivan Flores Heilbron had to be cut from his van. He was flown to Grant. He did not survive. Five Jefferson Township firefighters also had to be treated there. Two of them suffered cuts while removing the driver of the semi. Three others were treated for heat exhaustion.
Happening today, the funerals are set for three little girls who were killed in a house fire in the Hilltop. Here are the pictures of 10-year-old Diamond, 8-year-old Lariah, and 7-year-old Heaven Roebuck. They were trapped inside their home when it caught fire early in the morning along Midland Avenue last month. Their family remembering the girls and their vibrant personalities.
They were all really spunky little girls, great attitudes, personalities, and it's just really, really sad and devastating what we're going through.
So far, the cause of the fire has not been released.
It is 6:05. Coming up on Good Day Columbus, restoring access to abortion services.
What President Biden is considering to get around bans that have gone into place since the overturning of Roe v. Wade.
Continuing coverage this morning, President Joe Biden says he's considering declaring a public health emergency in support of abortion access across the country. This comes after the U.S. Supreme Court overturned Roe v. Wade last month. A public health emergency is made in the case of disease, outbreak, or other health crises and unlocks certain government powers and funding sources. Biden told reporters while on a bike ride, he has limited executive powers to go further, but protesters need to keep fighting.
Yes, keep protesting, because keep making your point. It's critically important. We can do a lot of things to accommodate the rights of women in the meantime, but fundamentally, the only thing that's going to change this is if we have a national law that reinstates Roe v. Wade.
Congress will gavel back into session this morning after a two-week break. The House expected to tackle two measures involving abortion. One would protect women who need to travel to seek an abortion if they live in a state that now bans it. A second bill is an updated version of the Women's Health Protection Act, which would codify abortion rights into law and expand on Roe's protections. They are expected to pass the House but fail in the Senate.
A pregnant woman in Texas plans to fight a ticket for driving in an HOV lane. Her name is Brandy Matone, and she's arguing that the reversal of Roe versus Wade means her unborn child counts as a passenger.
I got pulled over, and the officer said, okay, well, you're in an HOV lane. And I said, yes. And he said, great. Is there somebody else in the car? And looking around, I said, well, yes, there is. And he said, well, where? As he's peeking in the car, and I pointed to my stomach. I was like, we're right here. And
Brandy plans to fight the ticket in court on July 20th. Pro-life group Texas Alliance for Life argues that Texas may recognize an unborn child as a person, but the Texas Transportation Code does not. Well, coming up, despite a slowing economy, businesses are still hiring.
But that may actually be a bad thing for the prices you're paying at the store. We'll explain after the break.
Plus, out of control, a wildfire is burning closer to the famed giant sequoia trees of Yosemite National Park. And it's getting bigger. What is happening right now to try to save this area?
And I'll tell you what, if you got the day off of work today, it's going to be a great day if you want to go play some golf. Maybe go to the pool. We get to 89 for the high, so it will be a very warm day, a hot, albeit. Coming up, though, we're going to time out some rain with Futurecast. Stick around.
New video this morning of some relief at the pump. This is along Cemetery Road in Hilliard, where a couple of stations have gas for $4.38 a gallon. Now, just a month ago, prices across central Ohio had topped $5 a gallon. It's not just Hilliard where prices are falling. They are falling across the state and country. Here's the latest statewide average from AAA. You can see it's $4.57 a gallon, down 17 cents over the last week. The national average, $4.67. That's down 13 cents in the past 7 days. More jobs were created last month than expected, but it may not actually be good news. This morning, one economist is actually suggesting the job numbers could make inflation worse. National correspondent Kayla Gaskins is in Washington with a mixed bag of economic indicators.
The recent jobs report, better than many anticipated. Nearly 375,000 jobs added last month. The country regaining almost every job lost in the pandemic. Average Americans, however, still not feeling great. Grocery bills remain high. The sticker price at the pump still painful for many to look at. 87% of Americans reporting anxiety about inflation.
Americans are feeling that, and I think that is largely the reason folks say, as you said, we're headed in the wrong direction.
The high inflation and low unemployment combo is a phenomenon the U.S. economy has not experienced in 70 years. Talks of a possible looming recession continue.
You know, I was just talking to a CEO of a big company, and he said, The economy's strong. Customers are buying. Businesses are strong. People are adding jobs. He said we're trying to talk ourselves into a recession. And I agree with that.
June's unemployment numbers may ease some fears about recession, but not all.
You don't need 4 years at Dartmouth Economics to know that when you add that $5 trillion, there has to be some outcome. The more this administration keeps telling people that a recession isn't inevitable, of course it is.
Former Clinton Treasury Secretary Larry Summers stands behind his argument millions of Americans may need to lose their jobs for inflation to drop. Summers telling the London School of Economics unemployment needs to be at a 5% rate for 5 years to contain inflation. A tough idea to swallow for many. With Americans paying closer attention to the midterms than in previous years, the vast majority of the country maintain the economy will play a factor in how they vote. In Washington, I'm Kayla Gaskins.
We are at 6:15 right now on your Monday morning, checking in with your roadways that continue to move nicely for the most part. We're seeing that traffic is really light in particular places. We're not really seeing too much going on that's going to ruin your morning commute this morning. So 71 right here, Polaris Parkway, very light traffic, especially in those southbound lanes, working their way in towards 270. We're also seeing the same thing over here. This is a pretty decent look at those north and southbound lanes that are moving right along. We're not having any problems over there on the north side, so you're really going to be in good shape if you're traveling. That is 315 right there that you're looking at the Bethel Road camera. So things are right moving along. We do have one accident to talk about this morning. Refugee Road at 33. This just came in on my board probably in the last 2 minutes or so. Doesn't appear to be causing too many problems. We do know that it's in the yellow, so there are restrictions in this area, but by no means are we getting reports that it is blocked. So just keep that in mind if you're going to be traveling a little bit to the southeast this morning. We're going to toss things back to Kurt.
Happening now, a fire that is threatening Yosemite sequoias and a nearby town in California Sierra Nevada Mountains is growing this morning. The Washburn fire has burned more than 2,000 acres of timber and brush. About 500 towering sequoias are being threatened. Some of the trees are more than 2,000 years old. Firefighters are using planes to drop water and bright red fire retardant. On the ground, hundreds are clearing dead brush and digging lines to halt its spread.
We're going full force on our suppression tactics.
Smoke from the fire is also causing major problems for the surrounding area. Amid a busy summer tourist season, up to 700 people who were staying nearby have been told to leave. Firefighters say it could take weeks to put out the flames. A day at the pool taking a terrifying turn in Las Vegas. Check out this whirlwind that hit the Luxor. You see pool furniture being blown into the air there. Several people were also knocked to the ground. There were no serious injuries, and that is something to see. Something you don't see every day down there for sure. Terrifying experience for people there.
Yeah, that's not where you want to be
Mm-mm.
when that happens.
What causes that, Buck, right there in the middle of a hotel pool
Probably
area?
Just, honestly, the building itself.
Really?
Yeah, you just get the weird winds coming mm-hmm. in. The other thing with the Luxors, too, is it's shaped like the pyramid.
The pyramid, okay.
So you get the stronger winds up top, the winds at the bottom a little lighter, so it just kind of causes that.
Interesting.
See, we're talking to the right person.
I know.
He knows Vegas.
He knows.
No
and he
Vegas.
Knows meteorology, so perfect.
Yeah, those two things coming together there. Yeah, and those, I mean, when you get those, it's not connected to a thunderstorm by any means, so
right.
It's got to be
beautiful
caused,
sunny day.
Yeah, typically really hot days because mm-hmm. you get that hot air trying to rise up, so.
Interesting.
That was pretty interesting. Especially there, you're laying at the pool, you don't
right.
expect something
Things
like that.
Things start flying through the air.
Wow.
Yeah.
Surprise.
Well, if you're heading out the door today,
mm-hmm.
it's going to be a good day to head to the pool here in Central Ohio.
Heating up again, aren't we?
Yeah, it's going to get back up close to 90 today, 89 degrees for the high. So take a look outside at our tower cam right now. Things are very quiet for us. Sun just popping up above the horizon for us. Time right now is 6:18. Sun came up about 6 minutes ago. 66 degrees here in Central Ohio, and we're dealing with the humidity going up a little bit. Dew points to 61 now, so it's just getting just a little humid, and it'll go up more as we continue into the afternoon. But we are dealing with clear skies, so again, a very sunny afternoon. By lunchtime today, we'll be in the mid-80s, and then topping out about 89. Wouldn't be surprised to see a few low 90s heading into the afternoon, and no major big impact as far as going out today. Yeah, we get to 89. It'll be warm heading outside if you're going to try to eat outside today, but
if you have a little bit of a breeze, it'll help it some. Humidity not going up too high. Now, if you need to mow the grass, just know tomorrow you may have wetter grass because we'll see some scattered showers and storms likely around this time tomorrow morning. So Tuesday, Wednesday is our best chance of rain this week. By Thursday, Friday, a lot of sunshine kicking back out. And if you're going to the pool or if you're mowing the grass today, the UV index is going to be very high. Could get sunburned about 15 minutes for any sensitive skin with our mostly sunny skies today. So let's show you some of this rain. Early this morning, we've got a little patchy fog. Futurecast is really picking up on it, but it's not really too bad in most of the area this morning. I'll show you the visibilities coming up here at 6:30. But right now, we're looking at pretty sunny skies through the afternoon. And then tonight, a little bit of rain in far northwest Ohio here at 10 o'clock. As we go through the overnight hours, a few showers to the north here at 1 a.m. Could see maybe a few storms to the northeast and then southwest overnight. Now, Futurecast is having this dry pocket over central Ohio. Few of the models are filling this in a little bit more. So there's still that chance of rain overnight. Then what's down by Dayton and Cincinnati kind of ramps up and goes across southern Ohio early tomorrow morning. Here's 5:30 in the morning. This is 7 a.m. tomorrow. So again, some scattered showers and storms late tonight between about midnight and daybreak. And then in the afternoon, very slim chance of maybe a stray shower trying to pop up in the afternoon tomorrow. But most of us continue to stay sunny and dry the majority of tomorrow, and then just a slim chance of maybe a little rain popping up on Wednesday. So I'm really focusing on these because if you're outside, you're at the pool, you get caught off guard with some of that spotty rain. But I think a lot of us will be staying dry most of the next 5 days, and even into the weekend, it's looking pretty good. 88 on Saturday, we got about a 40% chance for some scattered showers and storms Sunday. 89 degrees for the high on Sunday for us. So temperatures running pretty close to normal. 86 is our normal high, so we'll cool down to about 84 on Thursday, so 2 degrees below normal, but we'll have plenty of days where we're right near or just above normal as well. So not too far off of what we would typically expect for July, and we still have plenty of summer left, 73 days until fall officially arrives. And coming up in 30 minutes, we got your birthday shout out. So if you know anybody 90 or older, send me a direct private message on Facebook or Twitter. Got a few of them to highlight today.
All right, thank you, Buck. Well, there are a lot of couples out there that had their wedding plans ruined by the COVID pandemic.
After the break, hundreds are getting a chance for a redo. In just 2 minutes, the special and very unique ceremony. Plus, marching for answers. What the town of Uvalde, Texas says it deserves to know as the investigation into that horrific mass shooting at an elementary school drags on. Hundreds of couples are showing off their love in what they're calling a wedding redo.
So check out this ceremony at New York City's Lincoln Center. 204 couples came out to celebrate after many of them couldn't have ceremonies over the past couple of years because of the pandemic. They wanted to give it another shot. Yvette and Ken Roper got married in Vegas 3 years ago, then COVID hit, forcing them to cancel their reception. So obviously you're seeing folks are having a lot of fun there, but the ceremony is not legally binding. So it's more of just a replacement for a reception, it looks like.
Well, so many people went through this. Mm-hmm. You know, they tried to have their wedding, they planned it. Some people ended up saying, all right, well, we can't have the big wedding, so we'll just do a quick little,
right,
you know, quick and
dirty
wedding.
Scale it down a little bit.
Yeah.
And I saw multiple of those. I mean, I knew a couple through friends that they had this big, you know, luxurious wedding plan with 250 guests. They ended up just scaling everything down and having it in their living room of their home and making it just a very intimate type thing.
And now, chance for a redo. I get it.
Everybody,
bring the party on.
Hey, if you want to have a wedding, you should be able to have a wedding.
Agreed.
Well, coming up, we are following some breaking news at this hour at a business in Groveport.
Here is a live look along Toy Road in Groveport. There has been a report of a shooting here. Mike McCarthy is there, and we'll get an update from him live right after the break.
Good Day Columbus on ABC 6 starts with this breaking news alert.
Breaking news right now, the Franklin County Sheriff's Office responding to a report of a shooting in Groveport.
This is happening along Toy Road. That's not far from Alum Creek Drive. You see right here on a map. Our Mike McCarthy is just getting to the scene. He's live right now. Mike, what are you seeing in this area?
So, Katie, right now, this is a very active situation. There is so much we do not know. We are continuing to see, as we just come on the air here, additional police vehicles arriving out here. We are in an industrial complex near Groveport, a number of warehouses out here. We are at the Rickenbacker Global Logistics Park. That's where we are, and that's where there is a large police presence. You can just see one of the cruisers right here behind me. We're going to point our attention just right over in this direction to your left. There is a large police presence here from multiple agencies. And Chris, my photographer, let's really quickly, if we can, pan over here. You're going to see an additional SWAT vehicle arriving just right there. That is the Columbus Police SWAT vehicle. It is joining another SWAT team that is already here and in the process of getting in place. That is back in the area where we were just showing you across the way where all those police vehicles are located. The Franklin County SWAT truck right there, right beside where the Columbus Police SWAT vehicle also is now parking. We have Columbus Fire here with medics. We have Groveport Police. We have Obetz Police. And amongst all the police officers that are here, there are also so many questions and a lot of employees. This is a big crowd. I don't know exactly how many people, but easily more than 100 of the people I've been able to talk to. They've all told me that they work back here at this complex. No one seems to know for sure what has happened. Some of the employees told me they were on their way into work when they were stopped here. One of the workers did say they also had heard there had been a shooting, but beyond that, we don't have a lot of information. You can see there are members of the Franklin County Sheriff's Office right there in the middle of the street speaking with a couple of employees. The gentleman there in the black jacket told me that he was the plant manager, but he declined to comment any further at this time. We don't know exactly what business is involved in this out here. Again, there are a number of buildings all around us, but it looks like, based upon what we have seen so far, most of the activity is back towards this direction right here, right where you see, let's see who this is right now. This is Obetz Police driving by us right now. As I mentioned, most of the activity looks like is focused on this building that we are focusing your attention on right now, and it is labeled SK Food Group. We have also seen a number of people with that logo on their clothing. Again, we're talking about the people that are here gathered right by what is a retention pond in this industrial park. So we will keep you updated as we get more information, but there is a report of a shooting here this morning. We do not know whether or not for sure anyone has been injured and the extent of what those injuries could be or how many people are involved. One quick traffic note for you. Chris Baggs, my photographer, we're going to spin around real quick just to give you a look. They have shut down the entrance here to this industrial park. So there is a long line of cars going out onto Alum Creek. There is also an additional scene out on Alum Creek Drive. Some police vehicles there stopped on the highway there, or at least on Alum Creek Drive. We do not yet know what that is. And Chris, my photographer, we're just kind of seeing this develop here live, so bear with me as we kind of walk through what we're seeing. If you zoom right across the way there at that other building, you can now see there are police officers from Obetz, it looks like, responding to that building as well. So that is an additional building that we are just seeing. That is new within the last 15 minutes or so. Those vehicles from police were not there as we made our way here to our live location. So we're going to be following up to see what's happening there as well. We have reached out to a number of agencies, including the Franklin County Sheriff's Office, but so far we have not heard back yet from any officials. So clearly there is a lot of concern. We don't want to report or speculate on what we don't know. We are sharing what we are seeing and what we know at this point. Kurt and Katie will wrap up this report right now. We're going to get back on the phone. We're going to try to talk to some more people out here in this crowd. We'll check back in with you just as soon as we can with hopefully some clarification on exactly what's happening out here. We're live on your side on this breaking news out near Groveport. Mike McCarthy, Good Day Columbus.
All right, Mike. Jessica Ralston also heading to that scene, and we'll continue to follow this throughout the morning. We'll also be sending you push alerts as we get new info. You can download our ABC6 app to get those. Buck?
All right, good morning, everybody. As you are heading out the door here this morning, we are dealing with temperatures on the mild side for us. Taking outside here in Columbus, we're at 66 degrees. Clear skies. Newark, the sun is just starting to pop up above the trees there, 63 degrees. And Circleville at 64, and then out to the far east, Cambridge, cooler at 60, but we are dealing with a lot of sunshine already out there this morning. It is going to be a bright day as you're heading out the door here in central Ohio. We talked about the fog earlier. Visibility down to 6 miles in Newark. We were just showing you the camera there. It doesn't look too terrible. So there is a little bit of valley fog that we typically see when we're on these slightly humid days. But all across the state, we're seeing sunshine. So take the sunglasses, you're heading out the door, and your Tempstar Heating and Cooling Products map showing those temperatures running pretty close to what we would expect for the middle of July, now that we're heading into that. 70 degrees here early this morning by about 8 a.m. We heat up to 84 by lunchtime, start to get warm, and then we top out at 89 today. A little bit of a breeze coming out of the southwest, but a lot of sunshine moving forward. Tonight, we're going to be tracking some rain on Futurecast. Good morning, Katie.
Hey, good morning, Buck. We're at 6:35 right now, just working our way through this hour. And I'll tell you what, we're still doing well. Happy to report traffic picking up just a little bit, but still moving nicely pretty much everywhere that we're looking this morning. 71 at Hudson, those north and southbound lanes. Really can't complain about what we're seeing there on that camera view, or down to the south, just a little bit busier right here by Frank Road, but still moving with plenty of room to get more people out and about. Big picture showing that everything's still in the green. We're looking good, especially in towards downtown Columbus. One little dot that still remains on our board. That's Refugee Road at 33. Let's check in with Mike Kilburn to see how he's doing in Mobile Track, if he's anywhere near this accident or what he is checking out this morning. Mike.
Yeah, good morning, Katie. We are obviously stuck in traffic on Torrey Road. As Mike McCarthy has said, the entrance is shut down and a lot of traffic in this area. Let me take outside Mobile Track. You can see some of the employees that are outside of the building. Of course, we're able to zoom in with our top camera here, and you can actually see the number of people outside. I think Mike McCarthy was talking about maybe 100 people. Now, I can't tell you, on my way down here, no less than about 7 or 8 unmarked Explorers that look like potentially SWAT personnel arriving on scene. And it's interesting to note that we continue to see more and more emergency personnel respond to the scene. So, again, we don't have a lot of information as to what's going on, but we'll continue to follow it. And, of course, if we can work our way around, make some phone calls as well, we'll work on this to see what we can find out and update you. Reporting live on your side in Mobile Track, I'm Mike Kilburn.
This morning, Highland Park's business district is opening again for the first time since the July 4th parade mass shooting. That area has been blocked off with crime scene tape and barricades as police officers processed evidence at the scene. The reopening coming as funerals for the 7 victims are still underway. Police say that gunman fired more than 80 rounds into the parade crowd with a semi-automatic rifle. He's been charged with 7 counts of first-degree murder.
Hundreds of people marched overnight in Uvalde, Texas, demanding answers and accountability in the school shooting massacre. Organizers say the Unheard Voices march and rally expresses the community's frustration over the 21 lives lost on May 24th at Robb Elementary School. There's growing frustration over the slow pace of the investigation and who can be held accountable. The Texas House Investigative Committee's preliminary report could be released within the next 10 days.
The time is 6:38. Coming up, a popular star puts his world tour on hold. What it could mean for Shawn Mendes' stop here in Columbus.
Plus, it's time for the All-Stars, the Ohio MLB players who may make the roster when Good Day Columbus is back in 2 minutes.
New this morning, the 2022 Major League Baseball All-Stars have been announced, and local baseball fans will have something to cheer about in next week's game. Luis Castillo will be the Reds' lone representative this season. Despite the Reds' lulls, he has shined, striking out 74 guys in just 71 innings, and he holds an ERA under 3 at 2.92. Let's talk about the Reds. They were at home this weekend taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. Since he doesn't just win Sunday's game, they sweep the Rays in a 3-game set. They'll have today off before traveling to New York to take on the Yankees tomorrow. And from Southern Ohio to up north, the Guardians will be well represented at the All-Star Game. Cleveland securing 3 All-Star selections: third baseman Jose Ramirez, second baseman Andrés Giménez, and closer Emmanuel Clase. The Guardians would lose to the Royals in KC yesterday by a score of 5-1.
New this morning, Shawn Mendes' performance at The Shot later this year could be in jeopardy. Mendes has put his world tour on hold. The Grammy-nominated singer says that he's pushing back the next 3 weeks of his concert dates until further notice. He was saying this on social media. He's also saying that after speaking with his team and health professionals, he needs to take a break, focus on his mental health. Mendes is scheduled to perform at the Schottenstein Center on October 18th at 7:30, and so far tickets for the show are still on sale.
It's now 6:42. Next on Good Day Columbus, the Blue Jackets are about to hit the ice where you can watch them today.
And as we look live at downtown, it's Burger Week in the 614. We were going to show you a live picture, but we're just going to talk about burgers instead. There's some serious deals.
Sounds good to me, Buck.
I'm hungry. Good morning, everybody. Today, mostly sunny, but we will be tracking some rain as we head through the next couple of days. It's scattered, so not everyone's going to see it. We'll time it out for you hour by hour coming up.
We continue to follow breaking news right now. There was a large police response to a report of a shooting at a business in Groveport.
Our Mike McCarthy is there live right now. Mike, we just learned new information moments ago. What can you tell us?
Katie, just before this report, I'm talking about seconds before this report, I just spoke with the public information officer for the Franklin County Sheriff's Office, who is now confirming this was a shooting here this morning at this business park in the Groveport area. One person right now is being treated at a Columbus hospital. That person is in critical condition. We do not yet know where that employee worked or if that employee, or if that shooting victim was an employee out here. It certainly would appear that that's the case. There is no one in custody. We keep telling you about the large police presence we see out here. Let's show it to you right over there across the street from where we are live, right across in a retention pond here at this business park. The SWAT team from Columbus Police and the Franklin County Sheriff's Office is here right now. We are also just getting word that what they are doing is they are going into these buildings and they are just checking on the situation to make sure there is no longer a threat here. Any employees that they find, we are told that they are being evacuated and brought outside. And that brings us here to this big crowd where we are live here. We are at the Rickenbacker Global Logistics Park, and these people here have told me that they work back here in at least one, if not more, of these buildings. We can tell you that the sheriff's office has been here speaking with these workers as well. A number of sheriff's employees have been speaking with people like the plant manager, who so far has declined to comment to us on exactly what he is aware of at this point. We also told you about a second location, a second scene over on Alum Creek Drive. That's back in this direction. You can see the traffic back up. You cannot see the second location, but it's just up and to the left of the intersection. If you can see the traffic lights in the far distance, the second scene we're talking about is back that direction. What we are hearing and what the sheriff's office is saying it's heard as well is that there is a report that someone climbed a utility pole in that area, and there was also a report of an electrocution there this morning as well. I want to be very clear that we're reporting that now because the sheriff's office has told us it is something that it has looked into as well, though it did not respond directly to that incident. We know medics did respond to that situation where, again, there was a report of an electrocution, and there are questions right now whether or not that is related to this. It may be the case, and we're reporting that because, again, that's something that investigators are looking into, and the two locations are very close to each other, less than easily a mile apart. So to recap the new information we have right now, we're at the Global Logistics Park in the Groveport area. We have a confirmation of one person being shot and being treated right now at a hospital in critical condition. And bear with me here because I'm going to look around because we are hearing a lot of sirens. And I'm trying to see if we can see any additional officers arriving. We don't yet know where they are going. There are multiple buildings out here, and we have seen police outside multiple spots out here. Again, we don't know what business was involved in this. We will keep you updated as clearly the situation is evolving as we apparently have additional police presence responding out here. We'll keep you updated as we get more at ABC6OnYourSide.com and also join us on Fox 28 starting at 7. We're live on your side on this breaking news near Groveport. Mike McCarthy, Good Day Columbus.
All right, Mike, thank you. 6:49 here. Looking ahead, the final two scheduled hearings for the January 6th committee will happen this week.
It will include video testimony of former Trump White House counsel Pat Cipollone. ABC's Alex Prochet is in Washington right now with a look at what we can expect to see and hear.
For the first time, the public is expected to hear from former President Trump's White House counsel, Pat Cipollone. Last week, the highly anticipated witness spent 8 hours speaking with lawmakers behind closed doors. Cipollone, who was with then-President Trump during the assault on the Capitol, was repeatedly mentioned during testimony last month by Cassidy Hutchinson, a former aide to the president's chief of staff, Mark Meadows.
Mr. Cipollone said something to the effect of, please make sure we don't go up to the Capitol, Cassidy. Keep in touch with me. We're going to get charged with every crime imaginable if we make that movement happen.
On ABC's This Week, Illinois Congressman Adam Kinzinger, who sits on that committee, says Cipollone's testimony did not contradict that of other witnesses.
You'll see over the next couple hearings a little of what he said. Certainly you'll see a lot of that in the report. But at no point was there any contradiction of what anybody said.
When asked about a Washington Post report that former President Trump is considering waiving his claim to executive privilege for his former chief strategist Steve Bannon, Representative Kinzinger said the committee welcomes anybody who didn't testify before.
Anybody that wants to come in that knows information to talk to the select committee, we welcome them to do so. We welcome them to do so under oath.
ABC News obtaining a letter from Bannon's attorney to the January 6th committee where he says Mr. Bannon is willing to and indeed prefers to testify at your public hearing. Meanwhile, Wyoming Congresswoman Liz Cheney, who serves as vice chair of the committee, says the hearings will give the public a chance to hear how the former president sent a violent mob to the Capitol and failed to immediately stop the violence. She's also promising a moment-by-moment account of the attack from several Trump White House officials. Alex Brochet, ABC News, Washington.
All right, well, let's get right to it here this morning. We got three birthday shout-outs to get to. First of all, we've got Ed turning 91, Dale 92, Betsy 90, and William turning 90 as well. So happy birthday to all of you. And if you know anybody celebrating a birthday 90 or older, send me a direct private message on Facebook or Twitter the morning of the birthday. Sun's up now. We're already at 66 degrees. Southeast winds at about 3 miles per hour. And if you want to send in your photos of the sunrise like Kathy did here, nice start to the morning. By noon, we're already at to 84 degrees. I'm going to skip forward over a couple of scenes here just because we're running out of time with the breaking news we've had. Mostly sunny today. This weekend is going to be hot and humid. Right now, we're in the mid-60s. Let's time out a little bit of rain for you real quick. So today, building clouds in the afternoon, but still pretty sunny. 89 for the high. Rain starts moving into northwest Ohio this evening. 11 o'clock, most of it's out of our neck of the woods. But overnight tonight, thunderstorms racing across southern Ohio. This is 5:30 in the morning. So the best chance of rain is going to be early tomorrow morning. And then moving ahead to Wednesday, 85 for the high. By the time we get to later this week, we stay in the mid-80s. A little bit of rain on Sunday. Sorry this was so fast with the breaking news. We'll have a full extended forecast coming up on Fox 28.
Breaking news right now, we continue to follow a workplace shooting.
One person is in critical condition. Our Jessica Rolston is just getting on the scene. Jess, what can you tell us? I'm sure there's a lot of action out there.
Yeah, and you actually just missed a lot of it. There's been a big flurry of activity here on Toy Road in Groveport. We're right outside, about a half a mile away from SK Food Groups. That is the scene of the shooting incident this morning. You just saw a Franklin County Sheriff rushing by. Just before we came on here live, we saw the bomb squad come speeding past along with another sheriff's deputy. We've also got SWAT out here and many police units coming together to contain this scene. Again, there was a shooting in this plant early this morning, and the Franklin County Sheriff's Office saying they do not have a suspect in custody. So right now there are hundreds of workers standing outside of the plant, and actually we've seen many of them leaving, walking down Toy Road here all together. So no one would say where they were headed to, but they're trying to get people away from this plant as they search for a shooter. One employee did tell me, this is not confirmed by police, but they believe this was possibly a domestic violence incident where a man shot his girlfriend here around 5:22 this morning. Again, that's not confirmed by police. That's what workers at the plant are telling me. It is a very active scene out here. We're on Toy Road. The traffic is backed up. People have been at a standstill for just about 30 minutes or so here. Basically, the road is blocked off. There's nowhere to go. If you do have a family members at work here or friends, please give them a call and check on them. And of course, we will be here live on Good Day Columbus with team coverage throughout the morning. I'll check in with you again at 7 o'clock.
And Jessica, the Franklin County Public Information Officer for the Sheriff's Office just said that they confirmed that that victim was taken to Grant Medical Center. So they are there for treatment.
And as she mentioned, she's there. We have Mike McCarthy there. We will have team coverage throughout the morning over on Fox 28.
All right. Thank you for joining us here at 6.